other side. Oh, yeah. You don't want to go to the other side because it calls you to leave out of comfort zone.
That's right.
The text says, he says, let's go to the other side. Now, you need to understand that Jesus, he's very specific. He's very specific and he knows what he's doing and he knows how to set you up. Come on, somebody. He knows how to set you up and he knows how to prepare. He speaks about faith. Now it's time to live out what we're learning.
Amen.
We come to church every Sunday. Amen. It's very transparent that we do because I see some of you all that praising, worshiping God like you're out of your mind. And some of you all just sitting there, amen, acting like God owe you something. But either I know that you know something about church.
Yes. Oh, yeah.
Come on, somebody. And so God prepares them. He says, I got to teach you faith, and then you got to live what I teach you.
That's all right.
That's right.
That's right.
He talks in parables, amen, and he brings something tangible to become teachable. And come on, somebody. He knows who we are. We are finite beings, amen, and we need to see it. Come on, somebody. And that's the problem with the ministries, and that's the problem with pastors and teachers and evangelists and ministry. Amen. We preach that God is still able, but we live in that God wants us to see everything. Come on, somebody. Still everything that made the Hebrew people so distinct was that they served the God that they could not see, but yet had to still believe. It was not the color of their skin. It was not the fact that they knew God more. But they had to believe in God. And they could not see him.
That's right.
Come on, somebody.
Amen. Amen.
The text says, amen, that Jesus said, go to the other side. But something that I experienced in reading the text and it jumped out to me, Brother Billy Ray, that there was some more little ships out there with these guys. There were some more of the ships out there. And it is that we need to understand that we're not the only one that's serving God.
Amen.
All right.
Come on, somebody. I heard the prophet Elijah declare, I'm the only one serving Baal. I didn't bow down to Baal. I'm the only one that's worshiping you, God. And God had to declare to the prophet Elijah, I got 100 more prophets that ain't seen nobody yet, but they love me.
All right.
Give me somebody. There's some other folks out there love the Lord.
Oh, yeah.
There are 300 ships out there. There's some other ships out there. And the text says that a storm began to rage.
Yes.
Give me somebody here.
Yes.
A storm, my brother and sister, it is a violent disturbance. Amen. And the atmosphere. It is when the highs and the lows begin to meet in the middle and bring forth a disturbance. Come on, somebody. Some of us in this place, high blood pressure one minute, low blood pressure the next minute. There's a storm in your life. God is still able.
Oh, yeah. That's right.
There's a high and there's a low in your life, and it's bringing a disturbance and the